Today's video is sponsored by Paperlike, which makes writing or drawing with any Apple Pencil on any iPad feel more like paper. What installing iPadOS actually feels like to me is that I went out to the store and bought a brand new set of iPads, brought them home, and had two new devices. Hey, it's Chris, and yes, I finally got iPadOS loaded up on my iPad Pro 11-inch along with my iPad Mini 5. And yeah, even though this is a beta, I'm really loving this. It's amazing. By the way, I have to give a huge shout out to Lori Gill, aka Appaholic, over on Twitter. She's from iMore. She really hooked me up with the information I needed to get these loaded on to my iPads, so thank you. Before we dive in, let me just mention, I made an iPad video not long ago, right before WWDC, about all the little things that it took for me to try to use my iPad as a Mac alternative or replacement, however you want to say it or phrase it. And if you really want to see how much has improved in iPadOS, you have to go back and watch that video because iPadOS fixed almost all of that stuff. Seriously. It's a whole new experience. Now, I know a lot of people aren't gonna review the beta right now because it's so early, and things, of course, could change. Apple may change stuff around or even just throw some stuff out. But you know what? I'm too excited about it not to dig in and tell you about my experience right now, so we're gonna do it anyways. Disclaimer though, there's no way I'm gonna be able to cover every little thing in this review. There's just a million things that you notice as you're using it, like new scrolling bars on the side of Safari and a bunch of apps. Those are cool. New volume slider, that's pretty cool. New share menu, lots of stuff like that. But what I want to do is focus on some of the big things that I've been using and testing. Like the new home screen, which, man, I love this. I told you in that last iPad video that widgets were really like my jumping off point, how I got started when it comes to productivity. And so to be able to take those over from the side where you can't see them, where you had to scroll to get, where you had to swipe, and put those on the home screen where they're just always there, I love this. It makes my life so much easier. And now I think people are actually gonna start using widgets because I'm not sure how many people actually use those before because there's like out of sight, out of mind. Now that they're in front of everybody, I know I'm liking it. I think you will too. Really like the ability to pin two of your favorite widgets. I think it's limited to two right now, up to the top, and then you can swipe a certain direction and like hide everything else except for those two. So if you wanna like declutter it, which is great, no one likes visual clutter because that turns into mind clutter, then you can do that. You can hide those, or you can scroll down and then see everything that you've got loaded up there if you really need to dig in and get to stuff. So I've got like a calculator hidden down there and a bunch of stuff that is super useful, but maybe I don't wanna see it all the time. So yeah, loving that. Also loving the fact that I can fit more apps now on that home screen. So this makes a way better use of space. The iPad is much bigger than the iPhone, and so it didn't make sense to have all that padding and extra space in between apps. Now what you have is a denser grid of apps available, and it doesn't look bad. In fact, it leaves room for like more improvement. I haven't even filled it all up. And if you add Siri suggestions over in your widgets, there's like a ton of apps that you can fit here. The new multitasking is just amazing. Like, you see the smile because how many times did I sit here in front of the camera and say, I wish that I could have two of my notes from the same app open side by side. I said that in so many videos because I wanted it and it's finally here. And it works much better than the way Safari's multi-space view worked before. It's like more full-featured. It doesn't hide anything from one. It's not like one space or app or window is inferior to the other. It's like both full-featured, and I'm loving this. I can now reference something on one side in OneNote and write about it, make notes about it, drag and drop over in the other. And it goes beyond that. I mean, if you have mail open, let's say, and you just wanna drag out one of those messages, stick it over on the side, and it's in its own space over here, and you can respond to it, get rid of it, say done when you're done, and it goes away, I love it. There's also app expose. So if you have a bunch of notes open and paired, like split screen, with several other apps in spaces, or let's call them windows, then you can hit the icon down in the dock, and you can say show all windows, and it will show you all the places where that notes app or whatever the app is open. You can pick from it, and people are gonna go nuts with this. You're gonna have, it's like tabs basically for what you're doing, and you're gonna have so much stuff open, but a quick and easy way to find it. So this is great too. We also have an improved slide overview right now. So if you have three apps open, maybe two are 50-50 split screen, and this is the third one that lays on top in kind of a thinner bar, almost like iPhone size over there. Well, you can load that up and just keep dragging stuff that you want up there. So I've got like Twitter, I've got Trello, maybe YouTube sometimes, all kinds of stuff loaded in there. And just like on your iPhone, hit the bar on the bottom. It's almost like a second home bar. Swipe through that and just access whatever you want without having to mess with the dock and switch things and mess up your view and your layout. That's pretty cool. It's not exactly what I wanted. What I actually wanted was this concept, which I saw and which you might have seen. That I still want. I salivate over that. But this will do in the meantime. It's not new really and shiny to me. It's just kind of like extra, a little bit of an improvement on what we already had. But I'll take it. It's still useful. A huge update, they may not sound like it, but it's absolutely massive, is the fact that Safari now acts like a desktop class browser. This is going to fix so many issues for so many people. I know I'm already feeling like, wow, this is the one thing that, well, there's a lot of things. This is one of the things, though, a big thing that really makes me feel like this is a full-featured computer now. This is what gets you close to being a Mac replacement instead of just an alternative. I'll go so far as to say this is one of the biggest changes in iPad history. It's that big of a deal. All of a sudden, I'm editing my Squarespace sites. Squarespace, have you ever seen the controls for Squarespace? It didn't work well for a touch environment before. Now they pop up and you don't need a mouse. You wouldn't even miss it. It works really well. It's seamless so far for me. Like that was one thing where I had to use my Mac before, but I don't have to anymore. I'm becoming much more untethered. We also got some cool new shortcuts in Safari. In any app, you probably know, hold down the command key and it'll pop up on your external keyboard and show you what shortcuts are available for the keyboard. Well, there's a lot more now. And so you can like hold down command and click on a link and it'll open it in a new tab in the background. That's cool. You can do a combination, what will let you like download links. And then of course you have a new download manager. All that stuff is cool. It makes a difference. Now in my WWDC coverage, I saved dark mode until like way at the end of the video because to me, I thought it's not really a big deal. I'm moving it up in this video and talking about it sooner because I have discovered something about dark mode that I really love. And it's dark mode notes in Apple Notes. I'm addicted to it. There is something about writing on the dark background with white ink where it just pops off the page. And it's a whole new note-taking experience for me. I know it's the same as when you're in light mode, but visually, things pop off at you more. I feel like I can think clearer almost. It's weird. Maybe it's just psychological. I didn't expect to like it, but I've ended up loving it. I'm in there all the time. I'm coming up with excuses to make a note, like planning out all kinds of things just because it's so fun on the dark mode. The white pops, the white ink, and the highlights really pop and look cool. And what I love is that if you make a note in dark mode using that white ink, when you switch back to light mode, or maybe you have it set to automatic, when you get back into light mode, then the ink flips, it reverses, and it goes back to being black ink on the white background. So, really seamless. So, I underestimated dark mode, but I ended up liking it in ways that I didn't even think about. And so, maybe you'll be the same. Once you get in there and play around with it, you'll find something you really like. What I don't like, though, is your black icons. Those can be harder to see now. Okay, let's talk about some of these new text editing gestures. You're not supposed to really use a mouse with iPadOS. Apple still has mouse support as a accessibility feature. You can turn it on. I haven't tested it yet, by the way. I'm getting there. Okay, the new highlight feature, this has made a big impact for me already because what I like to do is research things before I talk about them here. So I'll load up a bunch of articles in Instapaper and I'll go through and highlight things and I'll annotate those and I'll export all my notes into like Apple Notes and then organize those into a mind map, whatever. So I do a lot of highlighting and it was really tedious and not that great before. Now, it's so smooth, so much faster. I'm also really into the idea of picking up text with three fingers and dropping it back down to copy and paste or copy, cut and paste. That works really cool. It works most of the time. Now, I'm in a buggy beta here, so maybe it's just quirky only because it's a beta, because sometimes it like minimizes stuff and you know, but I don't think it's gonna be a big deal once the actual public release is stable and comes out. So you're gonna like this a lot, trust me. The quick select of text is also very cool. So depending on how many taps you do, it'll select just the word or the sentence or the paragraph, or it can smart select like an address or a famous person's name. Oh, and we definitely have to talk about the three finger swipe to undo. So you can use three fingers, swipe left or right to undo and redo. This is much better than shaking your device, but it's a little bit tricky when you have an Apple Pencil over here. So if you're like sketching or doodling or handwriting and you need to undo something, you gotta like learn how to position the pencil in your hand so that you can get those three fingers down and do it. It's learnable, it's doable. It's not like a detriment, but it's just kind of awkward for me so far. But once you get the hang of it, it's a big upgrade. So there's a brand new Apple Pencil tool palette. So you know when you use the Apple Pencil in Apple Notes before, the tools popped up on the bottom and you could select and you can like hide it over in the corner. That's got a big upgrade. It looks better, a lot better. I like the new look for one thing. Like it looks way better. And number two, you can move it all over the screen. It doesn't have to stay stuck on the bottom. You can flick it up, it'll go to the top, flick it to the side, go to the side. You can hide it in a corner, any of the corners. Cause sometimes, you know, you're writing over here and the thing's in the way, just move it, you know? You couldn't do that before when you're trying to write on the bottom and it was kind of a pain to have to put it away, get it out. And so this is way, way better. And I've been playing around with the tools. One thing I discovered that I hadn't seen anyone talking about yet is the selection tool has a really cool feature now where instead of having to trace all around what you're trying to select and move, just scribble on it. Like just scribble all over it and Apple will just smart highlight that for you. It's way faster. You gotta try that. I mean, there's lots of little things to discover. That's what's so fun about iPadOS. I'm also liking the ability to switch the eraser between object erasing, where just you barely touch a line and the whole line disappears, and pixel erasing, where you can just erase, fine tune exactly what you wanna get rid of. Another absolutely huge improvement is the Files app. There's a new view, which is like the column view. If you're a Mac user and you're used to Finder on the Mac, you're gonna feel right at home here. Except maybe it's almost a little more convenient because now when you get over to whatever file you're looking at, you can see all the information about it, size, dates, all kinds of stuff without even having to right click and say get info. So it's much more powerful, much more informative. And you can also from that view, like rotate an image or mess around with the movie or click on the pencil icon and highlight and annotate stuff. It's just way cooler. Obviously a big ticket item that's associated with this is external drive support. And yes, this is cool. Yes, it works. Yes, it's amazing. The one thing that's not working yet for me in anything is the ability to go into an app like LumaFusion and edit something actually off on the external hard drive. Right now it copies it over to the iPad and that's not what I want. That's really not an improvement for me right now. So when and if that comes, and I think I've heard that it is, hopefully it is, that is gonna be just insane for me. Huge, huge. I can't wait. There's a new floating keyboard, and this is kind of cool. It broke my brain a little bit to use it, partly because it's kind of buggy right now in the beta to move it around, but partly because it's like you can reposition it anywhere and it doesn't feel like it goes there, you know, like I'm not used to it. But once you mess around with it, it's one of those things that you're not gonna wanna go back. You don't wanna not have, especially because you can swipe now. And I talked about the swiping in the WWDC video. I feel a lot better swiping my information into Apple's keyboard than I do a third-party keyboard just for privacy reasons. So really glad that it's here. And the mini form factor that you can move everywhere, it really is useful. Oh, there's a new Reminders app. And I've told you guys that my life basically runs on Reminders, this app in iOS 12. The thing is, it's so buggy right now. I haven't been even able to use this. Like, it just creates like all these duplicates. Ah, I haven't been in there. That's something I'm gonna have to report back on. But know that I'm super excited and can't wait to tell you about it. Another thing that I was able to test though is being able to mark up and take a screenshot of an entire website. And it works with like documents and some other stuff too. So if you're in a web article, no more having to take like a bunch of different screenshots if you wanna share a lot of things from it. Take a screenshot and there's an option at the top to get the screenshot of the whole site. And then you can use your Apple Pencil to highlight, you can circle, you can do all kinds of stuff. You can save that as a PDF. And that is awesome, works flawlessly. And this has got me rethinking like how I research and do stuff. Maybe this is a better method of marking up articles than just reading them in Instapaper. I don't know, there's a lot of new things that may change your workflow in iPadOS. So I've really just barely scratched the surface of all the stuff that iPadOS can do. I haven't even come close to telling you about all the little changes in like settings that you can mess around with, the way to take screenshots with the Apple Pencil. There's so much more to cover, so make sure you're subscribed. I'm gonna tell you how life-changing this is in just a minute. But first, if you own an iPad or you're looking to get one soon, then check out today's sponsor, Paperlike, which is an accessory that makes it feel and sound more like using real paper when you're working with an Apple Pencil. Paperlike actually gives you more control when you're writing or drawing thanks to the paper-like resistance that it offers. And yeah, it really makes a big difference. Plus, it reduces glare and fingerprints, which, who wouldn't want that? Paperlike is great for anyone who wants to use apps like Apple Notes or Notability or Procreate or Affinity Photo, among many others. Not to mention the new sidecar feature coming to macOS Catalina. When you place an order, you'll get two Paperlike covers plus application accessories along with free worldwide shipping and a 100% satisfaction guarantee. Go ahead and order yourself a Paperlike using that link down in the description. So I put iPadOS on two of my iPads, the Pro 11 inch and the iPad mini 5. Now these are the same devices as they were a couple weeks ago, a couple months ago, and yet they're totally different devices. What installing iPadOS actually feels like to me is that I went out to the store and bought a brand new set of iPads, brought them home, and had two new devices. That's how different I feel like they are to me. I know what it's like when you're on YouTube and you're watching all these videos about something you're really interested in. You kind of get numb to it, and you're like, okay, I know all about it. But this is one of those things, iPadOS, once you get your hands on it and you start using it, it's gonna be like, oh, wow, this is something totally different. You have to experience this. And when you do, you're gonna be smiling as much as I am. Maybe more. I will say this, if you've been on the fence about purchasing an iPad, Pro or otherwise, iPadOS is definitely gonna move the needle for you. I'm sure of it, I'm confident of it. I mean, like, yeah, some people just hate iPads, fine. But if you're on the fence of something you were thinking about, this is the thing that's gonna get you excited about it. I love it. How many times can I say that in one video? I love it, I love it, I love it. Hey, if you're not following me on Instagram and Twitter at Daily Tech Spell Daily TEKK, you really should. Maybe you've heard me say this like a million times and spell that out like that. In fact, it's funny. Every time I tell someone about the channel, it's like, it's Daily Tech, but it's spelled Daily TEKK. I probably said that a million times in my life. If you have not followed me there, go do it. You miss a bunch of stuff, like at WWDC, all kinds of stuff that I don't put in these YouTube videos, other kinds of content. And so please go do that. I know that you'll enjoy it. It's worth taking some time out. I'm going to link up some other iPad videos down below, especially the one I referenced in the intro, because, wow, it'll blow you away how much things have changed. That's enough talking. I will catch you guys in the next video. Later.